viewers. This is Suya Bhatra Harida from APC Mahalakshmi College for Women. Today let's discuss about the topic Betatron. Betatron is a device which is used to accelerate electrons at high energies. He is the man who developed this device. He is Donald William Kirst. Shortly, he is called as D.W. Kirst. Then seeing into the principle, this principle is more or less similar to the principle of the transformer. In transformer, we know that if an alternating current is passed through a primary coil, an alternating magnetic field will be produced in response to it. So this field produces an induced EMF in the secondary coil. Likewise, here the varying magnetic flux induces an EMF tangentially along the circular path. So this is how, with the increasing magnetic field, the electron gets accelerated within that circular path of constant radius. In this slide, we are going to see about the construction of betatron. The betatron consists of an evacuated Doughnut chamber in which electrons are produced by indirectly heated cathode. The Doughnut is placed between two strong electromagnets. So this is the picture of the Doughnut chamber. In this picture, F is the filament source which produces electrons and K is the cathode, whereas R is the radius of the circular path. When alternating current passes in the electromagnet, the flux increases in the center of Doughnut. That is, flux gets concentrated at the center of the Doughnut chamber. Next, we are going to see about the working part of betatron. When the electron appears at cathode, that is K, in Doughnut tube, and the electromagnet gets energized, thereby it increases the magnetic field. Due to this, two effects will take place. The first one is induced EMF is produced in electron orbit by changing magnetic flux that gives an additional energy to electron. So this can be explained using the famous law, that is Faraday's law. In that law, it was said that induced EMF is proportional to the varying flux. So that can be written as E is equal to minus d phi by dt. And the second effect is a radial force is produced due to increasing magnetic field. Its direction is perpendicular to the plane of the electron orbit. Now, these two forces are made to be balanced. That is, magnetic force is equivalent to centripetal force. So that was written as QVB is equal to MV square by R. In order to get betatron condition, here I have started the derivation part from the Faraday's law. As I have already said, induced EMF is equivalent to the change of flux. So E is equal to d phi by dt, which is taken as equation number 1. Work done on an electron in one revolution can be written as W is equal to EMF into charge of electron. So E into d phi by dt. Next, work done is equal to tangential force on electron into distance travelled in one revolution. So W is equal to F into 2 pi R, which is equal to E into d phi by dt. So from that, F can be written as E by 2 pi R into d phi by dt. So the electron moves in circular path. The magnetic force is balanced by centripetal force. So EBR is equal to mv. mv is nothing but the linear momentum, so it can also be written represented by the letter p. From Newton's second law, radial force is written as f is equal to dp by dt. So instead of p, it is substituted as mv. So f is equal to d of ebr divided by dt. In order to maintain path of constant radius, f is equal to er of db by dt. So balancing both the equations, we get d phi by dt is equal to 2 pi square of db by dt. So integrating the above equation, finally we get phi is equal to 2 pi r square b. This relation is known as the Betatron condition. The electron which moves in circular path of constant radius, the magnetic flux within the orbit of radius r will always be twice what it would have been if magnetic field were uniform throughout the orbit. So next is energy gained by electron. The particles have maximum energy when the magnetic field is at its strongest value, but the formula used for the cyclotron will not work for this Betatron condition. So in order to obtain it, I have taken here E is equal to PZ relation, where P can be written as E by C. So instead of P, MV is equal to E by C. From that, E is equal to MVC. For electron in the stable orbit, that is for electron to be in a stable condition, both the forces, magnetic force as well as centripetal force, should be balanced. So from that, it is written as EBR is equal to MV is equal to P. Hence, energy of the electron can be given by E is equal to, capital E represents the energy of the electron. So E is equal to B E or C. So this is the energy of the electron, electron gained energy within this Betatron device. Thank you.